Greetings, Richard Olivan here, and I'd like to welcome you to episode 1 of Undeniably Jamaican, a new web docu-series looking at Jamaicans in the diaspora who are doing things not normally associated with Jamaica. First up, we got Errol Kerr, a Jamaican skier who went to the Olympics in 2010 and finished 9th place in the world. I know what you're thinking, but this is no cool runnings. This year running's hot. Run the flim.
Well, who is Errol Kerr? I am the son of a Jamaican father, and my mom is American. My mom and dad were married for 10 years. My mom met my dad in Jamaica, and then they moved to Brooklyn, New York, and that's where I was born. When I was one, I moved out to the West Coast, moved to California, and moved in with my grandparents on my mom's side of the family. And they're a big skiing family, so they had a vacation home up in Tahoe. And so we came up there and went skiing on the weekends and holidays, and that's when I just fell in love with the sport. And that's when skiing really took over my life, and been skiing every day since, and all in this journey to get to the Olympics, and it all finally culminated in 2010 in Vancouver, where put Jamaica on the map by getting 9th place in the Winter Olympics. Well, when I tell people that I'm Jamaican and that I ski, you know, I think the first question that always comes to mind is, how do you train? Where do you train at? Well, you know, obviously in order for this to happen, it has to be a special scenario, and my scenario is very special. So I did all my training in Lake Tahoe, California, on the snow, and then beyond that, in the summertime, you'd be in New Zealand and in South America and kind of traveling the globe. So training was obviously not done in Jamaica, but Jamaica's in my blood, so that's how I become a Jamaican skier. Do people make jokes about Jamaican skiing? I think absolutely. You know, I think that the number one joke I always got was, oh, it's another bobsled team. I moved right past that by going out there and proving that I wasn't just another name on the start list, that, you know, I was competitive. I had just as great a chance to win as the next guy. So I think actions speak louder than words. So if you go out there and perform, you can, you know, shut up an entire world.
And there is your winner, Errol Kerr, to 17 hours to get here. Sean Palmer giving him a little advice, saying, this is what you do, young man. Let's check in now with Jamie Little.
Well, how did the Jamaica ski team come about? It actually started back in the early 2000s. There's a man named Richard Somm, and his son's Jamaican. And so his son was a skier and a ski racer, and so he wanted his son to compete in the World Championships in Vail, Colorado. So he got Jamaica recognized by FIS, which is the governing body over skiing. I just took that one step farther. I switched my allegiance from the US to Jamaica, so I'll never be able to ski underneath the US flag again, which is what I wanted to do. I wanted to go, you know, represent the land of my father. And so it was really helpful to already have FIS recognizing the organization, so that was a whole leap and boundary that I didn't even have to cross. Well, as far as my career in X Games, it's kind of what helped me propel to the top of, you know, the sport and to get the momentum behind me to actually break off and ski for Jamaica. So, you know, skiing for the U.S. ski team, it's you're fully funded and you have all your training, all your travel, and all those expenses are covered. So when I broke off to do my own program, I had to come up with about $250,000 a year. And so with that X Games career, you know, I finished, I made the finals, I believe it was 2008, and I finished 5th place. And that's live on ESPN and, you know, goes to 134 countries, and that kind of solidified me in the skiing world and really helped sponsors to get behind me and, you know, was no longer selling an invisible product. You know, I think I went out and blazed my own trail, and I think as Jamaicans, that's what we do in the world, you know, we just want to go out there and, you know, do something a little different and put that little island on the map.
See there? Look about with Talawa, Jamaica to the world.
All right, well, ski cross is, I think, one of, you know, the best forms of ski racing. I grew up alpine racing, which is against the clock. It's one person on a course at a time, and you're just timed from the start to the finish. Where ski cross is not a timed event. You have 4 or sometimes 6 competitors on the course at once, and the first guy to the bottom of the hill wins. In ski cross, it is a physical sport. There is no outside of the body contact, so I can't go and punch my fellow competitor, but I can definitely lean on them, and you know, you're always watching shadows and obviously trying to, you know, cut off the line and maintain your spot on the hill. Well, my overall Olympic experience, I think, was really amazing. You know, for that sport that I competed in from the age of 10, that was kind of where my eyes were set. So when you spend, you know, 14 years of your life focusing on something, that when it kind of, when all comes to be, you pretty much have already lived that whole scenario through in your head. And, you know, on race day, it was just another race day, and go about your business and do as well as you can. And, you know, at the end of that day, when I got eliminated, I was very frustrated. I believed in my heart that I had a lot, you know, had a lot more in me. I thought I was going to, you know, do a lot better than ninth. And I was very frustrated. But now that, you know, 3 years have passed, I really couldn't be, you know, more proud. It's something I'll have for the rest of my life. Not only am I an Olympian, at one time I was the ninth fastest skier in the world. And no one can ever take that away from me. And it's something that I'll die with. And not only that, I did it with Jamaica on my back. So it was a really, really, I think, life-changing experience. I would be so proud to see Jamaica do better than me next year in Sochi, Russia. It's, you know, I'm not sitting here hoping that they don't do well. I'm sitting here hoping that they win. And I feel very proud to be the first one. Well, you know, when I hear the word Jamaica, what comes to my mind is my mom, because my mom graduated from Stanford and ended up traveling the world and stopped in Jamaica and was hitchhiking, and my dad picked her up, and she didn't leave the island. She lived there for 10 years before they moved off the island. And so it's how much Jamaica changed her life, changed the path that she was going down. And you know, it's really her stories. I myself did not have an opportunity to actually live in Jamaica. I've been there a lot. I have a half brother who still lives on the piece of property that my parents lived on, and he has three kids now. So I think Jamaica to me is you know, it's what it's done for my family. It's how it's changed the path that my mom's been on, and I mean, made me who I am. I mean, you know, I took Jamaica, went to the Olympics, and got ninth. So what is Jamaica? I think for me, it's the people, it's the love, and I think it's just a different way of thinking. What parish do I represent? I represent Westmoreland. My family's from Williamsfield. I'd say my favorite place in Jamaica is definitely in Otarias. That's where I've spent probably most of my time on the island. It's either been in Otarias or up where my family's from in Williamsfield, and then in Kingston, you know, meeting people. Is there any desire to build something of my legacy? Obviously, there is a huge desire to do that. You know, back when I was, you know, skiing for Jamaica and going to the Olympics, I'd go there and I went to the Ministry of Sports and I tried to get these BMX tracks to go in, because that was a sport that I grew up doing, and that's something that, you know, we can do on the island. It's very inexpensive, and it's a really great way, you know, again, for youth to put their minds to something. It's an Olympic sport. It's in the Summer Olympics. Very inexpensive. You know, it's just a single speed bicycle. And that was always my dream there, is to build a BMX facility and something that, you know, we could have a Jamaican BMXer on the Olympic podium. Where's Errol Kerr today? Well, Errol Kerr is living in Reno, Nevada, and has now started an aerial cinematography business called Copter Kids. The website's copterkidsllc.com. And through that, I no longer have time to train, so I will not be able to be back in 2014. But have a great thing going, and hopefully one day Jamaica's back on the map as being one of the best aerial cinematographers in the world. I think it's such a brilliant, brilliant little island and brilliant people, and I think we're gonna do great things.